Okay, now we know, added to the uncensored events, Hacksaw Jim Duggan has agreed to face Ming in a martial arts match. What's wrong? Is your underwear too tight? What's wrong?
Duggan said, okay, I'll have the match with Ming.
Yeah, martial arts.
After watching what Ming just did?
Yep. Lord, would you stop it, please, and get back to the... Lord Steven Regal, uncensored, is going to be exactly what the name implies. Can you imagine a martial arts match, Ming and Hacksaw Jim Duggan, King of the Road match, Dustin and the Blacktop Bully, boxer versus wrestler, Johnny B. Bad, Arn Anderson, Nasty Boys, Harlem Heat, the Macho Man and Avalanche, Sting and Bubba, and then that strap match with Vader, Flair in his corner against Hogan? Well, what a big event this is going to be, Brain. Only... an event so wild, it can only be seen on pay TV.
And Duggan said he'd get in the ring with me, right? Martial arts.
Yes.
They're going to have to send some search team out to find the 2x4 when Ming's done with him.
Oh, boy. All right. Lord Steven Regal. Before this match gets underway, Brain, I want to get your comment this morning on WCW Pro. And 9:05 Eastern, an up-close and personal interview with Diamond Dallas Page, and he literally walked out, was angry, and walked out on the interview.
Well, I watched it, as millions do across this world. And why shouldn't the man have walked out? The man was totally insulted. They tried to embarrass him. I'd have taken a walk along before that. Diamond Dallas, my hat goes off to you, my friend.
Well, the man who claims he has the strongest arm in the world certainly has a lot of friends to back it up.
Hey, lost yet in arm wrestling, has he?
All right, here we go. Against Mike Davis. Well, no, he hasn't, but he has certainly used every trick in the book. Mike Davis and Lord Steven Regal. Complete professional wrestler, scientific skill, Lord Steven Regal. Nobility and arrogant as well.
Oh!
Backhanded slap! And Mike Davis returns fire.
Well, that'll loosen what's ever left of your double whoppers in your teeth.
What's ever left of what? Into what?
You wouldn't understand. You have false teeth, right?
No, I don't.
Sorry.
Duggan will.
Yeah, he might.
Just get a one big long one for the front. He can use it to open cans.
Davis.
You know, Duggan is not as dumb as I thought. He's dumber.
Mike Davis is a strong young individual, but Regal.
Oh, he just knows his way around that ring too well.
Look at this. The pressure on the back of the knee, sending Mike Davis right down.
And he's got on the back of the neck and the chin, half an inch. He moves it over to the throat if he wants, moves it back. The man is he's a master.
You're watching a very solid, very snug neutral position by these two men.
There goes Davis's inability right there, his youth. Regal had smacked him around before. When he had a chance, he should have smacked Regal around. I can't help it, I'm sorry.
You like Lord Steven Regal, I know you've gone to dinner with him many times, but he is one arrogant bloke. Between the shoulder blades, Regal can systematically take you apart in the ring.
He's apologizing to his opponent for beating him up. Says he can't help himself. Get a load of that. Regal is incredible. Double underhook. Rolls him over. I think he has him where he wants him, Brain.
He knows he has the man. He can feel the power the man has. He knows what this man is trying to do. The man's not trying to do much, but trying to stay in one piece. So Regal's having fun with him right now. He's playing with him.
Cross him up in the crossface. It's a submission hold from Regal. And he's got it on, and Regal secures yet another win.
He beats you so many different ways.
And he is so precise in the ring. Oh, show us a little. Wait a minute. Show us a little muscle as well. That apparently Regal, the type of wrestler, as a fan does not appreciate his style, that can beat you anytime he so desires. Right?
Oh, he's just totally in command. And he's such a gentleman. Such a gentleman.
And he can take a beating. He can give you a beating. He's just one tough customer. Underhook. Thinks Mr. Davis over. It's just about the beginning of the end. His legs are tied up. He's not getting up. There's no place he's going. Hooks under the arm. Hooks the head. Crunch.
All right, Regal says he has something to say to Mean Gene Okerlund. Nice bicep as we go to Mean Gene at this time.
You have just seen Lord Steven Regal in action, a true blue blood in every sense of the word, from nobility in Great Britain. And Lord Steven Regal, I haven't seen a whole lot of you in recent weeks. What have you got up your sleeve?
In fact, I haven't seen you since the beginning of the year, since the end of last year, have I? Do you know my New Year's resolution this year?
What's that?
To get up an hour early so I can hate you for a little longer. Now, I have become rather weary. I have tried and tried. My patience has tried to the limit of all the peasants. I mean, as you can just see, why does WCW even let them in the ring with me? I tried to find a partner. I can't find a partner to help me in this quest to battle the forces, to strive forth, to bring out the true gentlemen that exist in this world. There is very few of us left.
Are you saying you'd like to throw your hat into the tag team ring, so to speak?
You know I would, Mr. Okerlund. I tried a while ago. It didn't work out.
No partner.
No partner. But the quest will continue. Until then, anybody that gets in the ring with me is going to get a bloody peasant fashion.
Oh, Bobby Eaton.
I heard you looking for a partner. How about it?
Bobby Eaton, a well-traveled veteran, has just volunteered his services, Lord.
Mr. Okerlund, I have traveled to 24 countries in this world of ours, and I am very well versed in many languages, but Swahili is not one of them. Could you please translate?
Bobby, you may need to hit it, pal. I don't think this is going to work out. Is that grits or gum?
Just go.
Okay, hurry. Yes, thank you very much. Well, now here's a young man with a...
Do you honestly think that I would let this bloody lowbred, this scruffy, dirty, grubby urchin with piggy little eyes? Where's he from exactly?
Have you ever been to Huntsville, Alabama?
That speaks for the piggy eyes. I bet he plays a banjo as well, doesn't he?
Lord Steven Regal, I thank you, sir. Stay tuned. We've got more action here on TBS when we come back. Oh, my.